welcome students for today's class. This class is the continuation of your last class, that is RDT 2.0. RDT is nothing but reliable data transfer. So today we are going to see the RDT 2.1. In this RDT 2.1, how the sender and how they are going to handle the garbage acknowledgement and the negative acknowledgement. So as you can see here, one picture is there. So what it is saying, you can see this is a stage where wait for call zero from above. Okay, so here we are going to send some of the things. So from where and all we are going to send, and here there will be the waiting for the acknowledgement or negative acknowledgement for zero. Let's take this is as your packet. Okay, this zero is nothing but your first packet. So what I have to do if I want to send the packets from one stage to another stage, I have some program code. How I'm going to write the program code? As you can see, we have already discussed in the last class, RDT_send of data. So it means that I'm going to send some of the data in through my RDT. So next, what I'm going to do? Send packet, make packet, zero, data, and checksum. So I'm going to send my packets with some data values and the checksums. So if any errors will be there, I'm going to send all the errors with that. Next, by using the UDT, you are going to send this object. Whatever we have taken the variable name, we are going to utilize. Once it will reach inside your this second stage, here you can see it will wait for the acknowledgement, like positive acknowledgement, otherwise the negative acknowledgement. So what it will do here, it will just wait for this call, like it has to wait for the call one from this, okay? Like it is acknowledgement received or negative acknowledgement. So in this receiver side, what will happen is it will receive the packet. And if it is not corrupt, then receive the packet. And if it has the acknowledgement, then receive the packet. It means that you are getting a positive acknowledgement. Next, what you are going to do, you are going to send the same thing to your wait for acknowledgement or negative acknowledgement one. Because when we will send any kind of packets, that time first, we are going to work out with the first stage. Okay, next acknowledgement receive or not, that will be for my second stage. So here I have worked out with my call zero. Now I have to work out for my call one, because in the call zero, I have sent already. You can see here. Now what will happen? I have to wait for my acknowledgement. So I have given some other name as one that I'm passing over here. So here what will happen? You are going to send the data, make the packet of the next packet, then data and checksum. In this way, you are going to send the packet. So again, it is going to receive in your first stage. So what will happen? If there is a received packet, if that is not corrupted, then you are going to receive the acknowledgement. But what will happen? Here in the second stage, if it is waiting for the acknowledgement and it received the negative acknowledgement, so what you are going to do, you have to send it back to the original place. It means that you are going to send it back to your source side. So here RDT received the packet, and if it is corrupt or if it is negative acknowledgement, you are going to send it back. You can see, you have to send back, send packet. You can match it with this. So you are going to send it back. And in the same case here also, if you are getting the negative acknowledgement, then you are going to send the packet to the source again. So here what we learned, if we are getting the acknowledgement, okay, then no problem. Send the packet, receive the packet, send the acknowledgement and receive the acknowledgement. Four stages you are completing. But in between, in the acknowledgement stage, if you are getting negative acknowledgement, then send back the same packets to the previous one or to the previous source and get it done once again and receive the packet once again. So here you can see this is all about your RDT 2.1, how it is working out. So now here you can see in the receiver side. So in the sender side, only it is having that. Like you can see here, it is sending the data, okay? If it is happening in the receiver side, in the sender side, this work has to be done. But actually in the same time, what is happening in your receiver side? Here we will see. What it is doing? Here you can see wait for 0, the call 0 from below. So here we have sent it as call 0 from above. Like we are waiting for the before the stage, whatever happened, we are waiting for the above stage to be completed. But as it is in the above stage, that's why here my receiver side, this stage will be in your below stage. And it is waiting for the one from the below stage. Now what is happening? You have to receive the packet. If it is not corrupt, then first sequence. What is the first sequence? Your first sequence is your first one. Call zero value. So you are going to receive the first sequence. Then what will happen? Extract the receive packet. These things have to be done according to our algorithms. So you are going to extract the packet. You are going to get the data. Then you are going to deliver the data. Then you are going to send the packets with the acknowledgement and some checksum if it is there. Then you are going to send it back. This is happening in the sender side. Then what will happen? Once it will be done, you have sent with the checksum, the acknowledgement. Then again, one more sequence was also there. So that was also will be in the waiting stage. Once the first sequence will get over or first stage will get over, then we will move towards our second stage. Here also same thing will happen. So RDT will receive the packet. If it is not corrupt, it will receive the packet. And if it will have the, then it has to receive which sequence number? Next one. Here sequence 0 was there. Here sequence 1. Once this part will be done, we are going to extract it, deliver it, and send with the acknowledgement and checksum to your sender side that we have received the packet. And this thing is going to work out. So this part is working inside of your receiver side. So now next, what will happen? Suppose if you got the negative acknowledgement, then what will happen? Suppose you got the negative acknowledgement in this stage. What you are going to do? You are going to send back to the sender side there itself. You are not going to get it back in the future. You are going to send it back there itself. And also, what will be the code for that? Once it will send back, it will resend you the packet once again. When it will resend you, that time again you can see same thing. Whatever has been written here, it is also written here. Because we are receiving the packets, right? So which packet we are receiving here? Because whenever we were waiting for the zero, that time we came towards your call one. But when we were in the call one, that time we came to know that in call zero, there were some errors. So in call one itself, you are going to receive the call zeros, again, the packets, everything. Okay, because you sent it back. So the time delay will be there for your call zero. So now the call zero packet things you are receiving here itself along with your call one. If the call one is proper, then you are going to receive it here itself. But for your sequence zero or for the first stage, you will have some time delay. Suppose in the case you are having this circular positions, it will be like rotation wise for all the sequences. Suppose now you have reached towards wait zero or call zero. So now here you got that in the sequence one, there was some negative acknowledgement and there itself you have sent it back. So now what you are going to do? You have to send the packets back to your sender side. When you have sent back to the sender side, that packet, the proper data values has received in your first call itself. So what you're going to do? When you will be here, you are going to receive the sequence one, okay? So the same thing will be there, whatever is there. So here also same thing will be there. So in this way, the receiver side, it is going to gather all your acknowledgement and negative acknowledgement, okay? So now here also same thing is that if you are having the negative acknowledgement, corrupted packet, send it back again with all your checksum values. So now, let's have the discussion what we studied here. In the sender side, there will be the sequence number, continuous sequence number added to the packet. We are going to add all the packets. So you should have. So there are two sequence number we have sent, 0 and 1. Must check if received acknowledgement or negative acknowledgement. We used to check this, these things in your sender side. So two states we have checked. Now one is your sequence number 0 and one more is your sequence number 1. What happened in our receiver side? We should check the receiver side if it is duplicate message. If the sequence number is a duplicate sequence number, we should ignore it, or we should indicate that it is a the expected sequence number was this, but we received that. So that will cause your negative acknowledgement. And also you should remember, the receiver cannot know if it's a last acknowledgement or negative acknowledgement. So the receiver, the sender side, it has to come like okay. If you are sending, then it will come like it is a last packet. Moving towards your next one, you can see the next version, that is nothing but RDT 2.2. It is a NAC, like negative acknowledgement free protocol. Here you are not going to find out any kind of your negative acknowledgement. Same function will be there as there in your RDT 2.1 using the acknowledgement only. But here you are not going to get any kind of your negative acknowledgement. So instead of this negative acknowledgement, what it is extra thing is having, what it will do, if the receiver sends the acknowledgement for the last packet, received okay. Okay, so what it is going to do, the receiver will send the acknowledgement for the last packet. Till that time, all the packets will be receiving in your all the packets will be receiving inside your receiver side. So receiver must explicitly include the sequence number of packets being acknowledged. Whenever it will receive all the packets, all the packets has to be included with sequence number. Duplicate acknowledgement at the sender results in the same action as negative acknowledgement. So it has to retransmit the current packet. So now we will see how it is working out in the 2.2, the sender and receiver fragments. Here you can see, here it is waiting for the call 0 from the above. So it has to wait for the acknowledgement 0. So this is all, this side, whatever you are seeing, all these things will be for your sender side. So sender FSM finite state machine fragment. So how it is going to work out? We know the data will be, the code will be same. You can see RDT, you are going to send the data, then send packet 0, data and checksum is going to send. Once it will receive here, it will wait for the acknowledgement. So here what will happen, if any corrupted data is there, so is acknowledgement received packet for 1, the sequence number, is it received? It will ask the question, okay? Because we have already came to the second stage. Then you are going to send it back. So again, what happened? Then receive the receive packet. If it is not corrupt, if it is corrupt, send the receive the packet of your next sequence number. If it is not corrupt and acknowledged, then receive the packet of your 0, the first one. So next, what will happen inside your receiver side, in the receiver fragment segment, for the wait for call 0, what will happen here? If the RDT received the receive packet, the corrupt one, then the sequence number 1 is going to receive the packet, because here we have already sent it, right? So here it is going to receive the packet where it has to wait for the 0. So you can see the call 0, in the call 0 itself, it has to wait for the packets and the sequence number has to be 1. Why it is like that? Because here we got some corrupted data. We have resent it and we got the packets of data here. And also, suppose you have some not corrupted data, then what to do? If it is not corrupted, you are receiving the first sequence. If it is also not corrupted, you will receive the second packets, right? If you have corrupted data, you have to wait for some time delay. So here, once you have received all the not corrupted data, then you have to extract the data, deliver the data, and you have to send to the receiver side that with all the sequence number, like which acknowledgement followed by your sequence number, that which one you have received, that you are going to send it back to the sender side. Now, one more is there, that is RDT 3.0. Here, what will happen is the channels with errors and loss. Here, it will have the channels with errors and loss. New channel assumptions, Underlying channel can also lose the packets like data and acknowledgement. It means that we know that whenever we are sending any message from source to destination, we may lose the data. But sometimes it will happen that you can lose the checksum, the sequence number, and also the acknowledgement. And also sometimes the retransmission of data also you may lose. What will happen in that time? How the human is going to handle all this lost, whatever is happening in between your sender to receiver? How you are going to do? So you are going to, the sender has to wait for the reasonable amount of time for the acknowledgement. What we have to do? Once we will send the packet, we have to wait that. We have to wait to receive the acknowledgement. But that time, it may consume some of the time period. And also, what we are going to do? It will read, suppose we have not got the acknowledgement. It will retransmit if no acknowledgement received in this time. The sender has already sent the amount, the packets, but the time also consumed, but the acknowledgement has not been received. In that case, the receiver can retransmit the acknowledgement. Okay? And if the packet are acknowledged, if the packets are acknowledged or just delayed for some time, then what it will happen? The retransmission may be duplicate, because suppose in the time period 5 milliseconds of time, the first acknowledgement has not been reached. So in the 6 milliseconds of time period, the receiver has sent again the acknowledgement, and in the 7 milliseconds of time, both the acknowledgement has been received. Like in the first one, whatever he has sent, and in the second one, that time this became the duplicate versions. So what will happen? It will be handled by the sequence number. How the sequence has been sent, in that way, the acknowledgement also will come and receive in your sender side along with your sequence number. Then if suppose you are not giving the sequence number, it will be very difficult to know that which acknowledgement has been received. So in the receiver has to specify the sequence number of packets once it is going to acknowledged. And also the sender has to use the countdown timer to interrupt after reasonable amount of time. Like if suppose a time out, it will give some 5 milliseconds of time, the acknowledgement has to reach. If it is not reaching, then the receiver has to send once again. So that time period countdown should be provided inside your sender side. Now let's see how this, whatever we have talked about now, how it is going to work out in the term of your diagram. Here you can see the call, 4 stages are there. Call 0, acknowledgement 0, call 1, acknowledgement 1. How it is going to work out for your RDT 3.0? You can see first these things will work out as I have shown you, that call 0, first you have to send the packet, receive the acknowledgement of the same sequence number. Then send for the second one and receive for the second one. But in some cases, what will happen if the acknowledgement has not been received? So the what to do that time? The code will be same. But here the new thing has been added over, that is start timer. So once the timer will start, it is going to wait. By the time the acknowledgement has not been sent back to your sender side, it has to wait for the second stage. And here it is going to stop the timer, because now this is the time for the acknowledgement 1. The acknowledgement 0 time over here itself. Now what will happen? Start the timer for your acknowledgement 1. And if when it will stop, whenever it will receive inside your receiver side. And the code, whatever you are seeing over here, everything is same like your previous one. Okay. And we are talking about now, if the packet is not corrupted, we are not going to use any corrupted data now. Because everywhere you can see, if it is not corrupted, how we are going to receive. So this is a diagram for your not corrupted data. But what will happen sometimes, you can get the corrupted data also. That diagram also we will see very soon. Now, here you can see, suppose acknowledgement 0 has not been sent and the time out. So what you're going to do? You're going to start the timer once again, because the acknowledgement 0 has to be sent back to your call 0. Next, what is you are going to do? Whenever you will send do like that time you will get the corrupted data. Okay, so you can guess that if the start timer has given back, and suppose I have some corrupted data, so what to do now? I cannot wait for this acknowledgement 0. I have to move forward. So now that time what will happen? So here it is going to receive. You can see here, receive the packet of 1, because the acknowledgement packet 1 is packet 0 is having some of the corrupted data. That time you have to go for your second one. Once it will be there, next what you are going to do? You are going to start the timer again, because here it has already taken the delay time. Once it will receive over here, you can see that here you are receiving the packet 0. Okay, so you are receiving the acknowledgement 0 in this stage, because you had some delay and the packet has been resent once again, and the acknowledgement also resent once again. So you will receive that packet in the time of your second acknowledgement. So now you are going to receive the packet over here. So this is all about your RDT 3.0 in the sender side. So now how it is going to work out, we will see in the diagram format. You can see sender receiver. So now first you are going to send a packet 0. In the receiver end, you are receiving the packet 0. Then you are sending again acknowledgement 0, and you are receiving acknowledgement 0. Send again packet 1, receiving packet 1. Send acknowledgement 1, you are receiving acknowledgement 1. Again, if you want to send some packet 0, you are receiving the acknowledgement also. Here, you are not getting any packet loss. There will be no loss. But suppose you have some packet loss, how you are going to do that? You are going to send the packet 0, you are receiving the packet. Again, you are sending the acknowledgement, you are receiving the acknowledgement. All these things are proper for your first packet. But in your second packet, you lost the data here. Next, what you are going to do? The timeout also happened, because you have already lost the data. So receiver has not received the packet of data. So what you are going to do here? You cannot receive the data also. So here the time out. You are going to resend the packet 1. So once you will resend the packet 1, so you are going to send the acknowledgement and you are receiving the acknowledgement. In the same format, it will be working out. So this is nothing but the diagram of your if you are getting the packet loss. Now you can see one more thing also, if acknowledgement will loss, and here you can see if there will be the delay in the acknowledgement, how the diagram will be. You can see here, this is send the packet, you are getting the receive the packet. You are sending the acknowledgement, you are receiving the acknowledgement, no problem in this. But whenever you will send the packet 1, you are receiving the packet 1. But while sending the acknowledgement 1, it got lost in somewhere. So what you are going to do? You have to resend once again, because we have fixed some of the time periods. So you are going to resend the packet 1. So that time you have to resend the packet 1 once again, and it will detect the duplicate, because here already packet 1 has been received. So it will find out that, oh my God, maybe my acknowledgement has not received. That's why the packet has been sent once again. You are sending the acknowledgement. Again, it is going to send it back. So this is the way if you are going to lose your acknowledgement. And what will happen if you have premature timeout or any delayed with the acknowledgement? How you are going to work out? You are sending the packet 0, receiving the packet, sending the acknowledgement, you are receiving the acknowledgement. And you are sending the packet 1, you are receiving the packet 1. But while sending the acknowledgement 1, it took some time, more than the fixed time. So what it is going to do? It has to resend the packet 1. So whenever it will resend the packet 1 again, it will get some detect of data. So that time already the acknowledgement has been reached. All these things will happen a very less time period of time, very less time period, within some milliseconds of time. Next, what will happen? You are going to send the acknowledgement once again. When we will send the acknowledgement once again, we are going to receive it. Here also you have received. Again, here also you are going to receive. What will happen now? Here you can see it will send the packet 0. Okay. Now you are going to receive this one and again packet 1. So you are going to duplicate it, will just remove. Next, we are going to see what will be the performance of your RDT 3.0. How you are going to utilize in your stop and wait conditions. It will give you the some of the formulas. If you have in the exam some 4 marks of question, how to calculate the performance, you can utilize this. Now, the term useSender will be your utilization, which will calculate the fraction of time the sender is in sending. So, how much utilization power you are going to find out by using the term useSender. Next one will be like example 1 Gbps, 1 Gbps, and then the link 15 ms propagation delay, 8000 bits of data. Let's take this as an example. How you are going to do? So now, time to transmit the packet into channel. How you are going to find out the transmission channel? So now, this one I have written as D transmit, L by R. The formula will be L by R. What is the L? The packet size. How much is the packet? 8000 bit packets. So L will be 8000 bits. R is how much? Here 1 Gbps link is there. You are going to convert all these things. You are going to write in the bits per second time. So once you will write, you are going to get the result. So that is nothing but your performance formula. If I will move towards how to use this stop and wait operations, you can see one diagram here. The sender is there, the receiver is there. The diagram will tell you that if how to calculate your round trip time. So here, the first packet is being transmitted at the time period t equals to 0. You can see the first line here, the first packet bits arrives. Now next, what is happening? Within this time period, our last packet also arrives with a proper acknowledgement. But so what will happen? Here I have received my acknowledgement. So here acknowledgement arrives, send the next one. We are going to send the next value. So the total round trip time period will be the sending of total packets to the last packet. So that is known as my RTT. So now how you are going to calculate your delay time periods and all. You can see how much time period the utilization. Here you have seen how the L by R, the transmission packets data, how you are going to calculate. You can see over here in this diagram itself, it will calculate RTT plus L by R. This L by R is nothing but this much. So RTT is from here to here. You can see I'm marking over here from here to here. But the first packet to last packet also, it took some time period, right? That much we have calculated already. That is L by R. So what will be my total time period from the first packet to the last acknowledgement? It will be L by R plus RTT value. That is my total time period. Now you can see in this diagram, in the sender side, the RTT, this total red color bar line, you can see that is my RTT. L by R, which one? This one. So my sender side, it will be U sender will be RTT plus L by R. But this L by R time period is my first packet to the last packet sending side. So in the sender, I should calculate this much. So L by R divided by RTT plus L by R. So in that, so whatever the formula we have already there in the last example, you can put the values, you will get the answer. So now here, what is happening? The protocol limits performance of underlying the infrastructure channels. So here in this way, you are going to receive all the utilization for your sender side. This is known as your stop and wait operations. And how in the pipeline protocol operation, how it is going to work out in your pipelines. So in your pipelines, you can see the sender will allow the multiple packets, like all the packets will keep sending and yet to be acknowledged packets. So there will be some sequence number of packets will be there, which has to be sent by using this pipelining. All the packets will be in the pipeline. One by one, it will receive. And then it will be yet to receive the acknowledgement, but it will keep sending all the packets. So this is nothing but your range of sequence number, it will increase. You can send more packets in this by using this pipelining. And buffering will be at sender or receiver side. As it is more packets we are sending at a time, definitely buffering will be there. And if buffering will be there, what will happen in the pipeline? You can see the data packets are receiving in this way, acknowledgement are receiving in this way. So it will have some congestion also here. So this is nothing but all about your RDT 3.0. So totally, I have explained you about your reliable data transfer, which you are going to get the question, total of 10 marks or 12 marks of question. Thank you.